This is possible to do now, and you should be doing it. One, price. Two, hopscotch. Three, experience. We'll do this in supermarkets. Lidl is a price-based business. Audi is a price-based business. Two, Tesco's and Sainsbury's are a hopscotch business. Three, an experience business is a Harrods. So that's the retail supermarket thing. And believe me, I've bought some. I've been round the Harrods food supermarket that only, I think, 100 people in this country can afford to live off. It is unbelievable. But they never deter from where they're at. It's high end and it always is. Tesco's, you know, you always find in a recession, it's Tesco's and Sainsbury's, those mid-level supermarkets and those mid-level businesses that always have problems. These guys saw to success in a recession. Lidl and Audi, they were loving it. Similarly, Harrods and Rolex. Do you know Rolex in the 2008-09-10 recession? Record sales. Unbelievable. It's these people, the hopscotchers, that have all the problems. And SMEs, unfortunately, most of them live in the hopscotch land. Monday they're price focused. Then they're not getting enough. Oh, so then they go, actually, we could really be an experienced business. So they become experienced business. And then they're not just quite making enough sales quick enough. This is why I wrote this book, by the way. It takes a lot of time to build an experienced business. But once you get there, my God, no one's knocking you off your pedestal. It is powerful. But then they're not getting quite enough sales, so they go into between the middle. They do a mid-level service. They do a Sainsbury's, a Tesco's, mid-level. Then they go to Lidl and Audi. Then on a Friday, they go up to Harrods. Then no one knows where you're at. When it comes to experienced business, now it all starts with the easy peasy. By the way, on this, I want you to choose which one you want to be. If you're a price-focused business, stay a price-focused business. If you're an experienced business, stay an experience-based business. If you're a hopscotcher, it's a race to the bottom because the market doesn't know where you're at. Experience starts with easy peasy. The more that it's easy to do business with you, the more people like it. You hear this all the time. It's so easy to deal with them. Their website is so easy. It's so easy to get through to them. Do you know what I mean? Their team is so easy to park near them. The more you can make it easy, the more customers are easy to do business with you. Be aware of the rise of self-serve, then humans when you least expect it. We sort of touched on this earlier, where I explained, imagine having people helping you take your food to your car rather than the checkout. People would love that. You got a shouty two-year-old that's screaming and crying, and they said, don't worry, we'll take this to your car, madam. Be like, I'm coming back here. This is my sort of place. You're going to need a brand Bible, gang. This is what you're going to need. You're going to need a set of commandments of what your business does so that everyone can see. Like for us, we use the basis. Our four commandments for my business is the four E's. Engaging, enthusiastic, entertaining, delivering experience. So we tell everyone in Party Man and Marsh Farm, that guys, that's not really the four E's, is it? You're not being very engaging, you're not being enthusiastic, you're not entertaining our customers, therefore we're not delivering an experience. So that could be we actually train people to say, it's okay to high five the kids as they come in. People love that, it's okay to use their names. Because you might want to work in Barclays as a cashier where you don't high five the customers there because that'd be weird, wouldn't it? Paying your mortgage off, boom, you know, oh! You know, so you need to understand that you'll need a brand Bible for your business because most people are over-professional and you need to tell them to be chatty. You've got to look to shock and awe your customers when they're least expecting it. When they're least expecting it. Don't tell them everything you're going to get. Surprise them. So like, you know, if you're delivering a bunch of flowers, little box of chocolates in there that might only cost you £1.50 that has a value of £10 to the customer. Brilliant. Champagne on arrival on a hotel, but don't tell them they're going to get champagne on arrival. Brilliant. Airport parking, you clean the car, but you don't tell them you're going to clean the car. You just work it into the cost. Wow, shock and awe, love it. Content is the easiest way of being able to master sales persuasion and communication, building a personal brand. But it's not a 5-minute job. Because me and that fella have been at it quite a while now. But little things, there's some just little wins that in the last 2 weeks, I've done more podcasts on other people's channels than I've probably done in the last 6 months in total. Like people, James, can I have you on my podcast? And I used to have to go to people. Now people come to me. I just trundle into the studio next door. I call it a studio, the room next door. And there I am. So if you're going to do content marketing and build a personal brand, here's the things that you need to do. You follow what we call the four C's. You've got to be consistent. You've got to have charisma. If you haven't got charisma and you want to build a personal brand around your business, pay for an influencer on Instagram or a celebrity to do it for you. It's not as expensive as you think. I quite like doing this stuff, guys, you know. I quite like being on camera. Hello. Not everyone likes doing that. I love the sound of my own voice on a podcast. I love being on stage. I love it. Like, I love being centre of attention. Now, whether you like my charisma or not, some people do, luckily. Most people don't, but some that do, good. Content. You've got to produce content all the time. You've got to be consistent with your content. You can't be boring. You've got to do it all the time. You've got to think like you're running a local newspaper. You know, a local newspaper don't just say, yeah, we're not printing it for the next couple of weeks because we can't be bothered. No, we're not going to print a daily newspaper because we can't bother. We're not going to do EastEnders for 6 months. It's got to be consistent content. And then you've got to choose the channels. Like, Tony should be, like, massive on LinkedIn for his business. Like, you need to own LinkedIn. And you need to be present on Facebook. But maybe mortgages are not so important on Instagram just yet. But I do think in 5-7 years, as the Facebook people move over to Instagram, I think it'll be important as much as Facebook. So you need to know the channels that you need to be on. Like, Jamie, like, you need to own LinkedIn, don't you? You need to connect with every electrical contractor and every architect and every local authority, FM management company that you can get your grubby hands on. Like, you need to be on all of them. LinkedIn's really important for the corporate stuff for flowers. Like every, you need to connect. You need to get LinkedIn Premium and connect with all the people that run these hotels, wedding planners, so they get to see your content. Don't sell to them, inform them. Basically, guys, this is the magic word. People want to buy, and they want to always buy from experts. The experts at Days Out, the experts at Providing Holidays, the expert dentist, the expert hypnobirthing lady, the expert electrical contracting company. And if they ring you up or contacting you knowing you are the expert, then price doesn't get into the situation in the first instance. If they don't know you, they go, oh, hi, I'm looking for a blah, 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 how much does it cost? If the conversation goes like this, hey, I've seen all your videos, I've seen all your content, I saw that article you wrote, I've read your book, I saw that article you wrote in that magazine, that newspaper, really love what you're talking about. Can I come and see you for a meeting if that's possible, see if you can help us? Do you see the difference between those two scenarios? This is possible to do now, and you should be doing it. But people don't do it enough, it breaks my heart. This is, you know, especially if you're in property, you know, every landlord needs to know you. That's how you get good property deals. The best estate agents need to know you. That's how you get good property deals.